Energy.
We are rocking.
With broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch, we're so gallantly
streaming.
It's a different person.
That our flag was still there.
They cheered? What are they saying?
This
one was like, oh. Let me tell you something.
Try and take Trump's ears out. Now you can take ours out. Like
I'm just saying.
Some ears.
I'm just saying. Everybody is getting fucked up now, right? I mean, Jesus. So that voice that y'all were just listening to, Ingrid. What is her name? I don't even know her name. I just know she's a Grammy nominated
Andress.
Andress. Good gracious. She was performing at a recent baseball game, Major League's game. I think it was an All-Star game they had. And it was pitiful. I mean, you heard it right there.
Did you? I don't want nobody to talk about Sexy Red ever again.
You're right.
That, ooh, baby.
Yeah.
Don't talk about Sexy Red no more. If this woman right here is winning Grammys.
Yeah, that's wild. Honestly.
Hey, she said she was drunk. She said she entered the rehab.
Drunk doesn't make you.
Dude, drunk don't make you do that.
Not to that level.
Maybe make you add a few extra runs.
She tried to get a cheap, and then it's,
I mean,
of course they had the like camera angle to one of the players, and he's like. Do y'all think this was worse than Fergie's performance?
Yes, for sure.
It definitely was.
For sure,
out of key a lot.
Worse than
Fergie probably put some in a drink. She probably did.
Fergie was just trying to put some extra pizzazz.
She was
it,
trying to do Marilyn.
It was awful. I was just telling Sierra, I'm like, the worst thing is, I've seen great singers try to put their own rendition on the anthem, and it flops. Like, I remember we were at one game, and we saw Anthony Hamilton do the anthem. Now, Anthony Hamilton can sing his ass off, but anthem-wise, he did his own. Like, I'm like, it's not
he
working.
He did a Charlene version of
He did
America.
A Charlene version of
America, if you're listening.
19,
you call me.
19 minutes and 45 seconds later. Because Anthony went to vamp through the whole thing.
People didn't know when to clap, when I'm like,
is it over?
It's too much, man. They're trying too hard. But we had to open that up to get, you know, wake everybody up. Look, welcome to In Your City. I'm your guy, Arrington Gavin. Joining me always, my family, comedian SyRok Foxx. Hey. Hustle Queen, Miss Michele Young.
Hey.
And awesome producer, Mr. Kam Godley.
Yo.
Oh, and back with us again, Alvin.
Hey, Alvin.
So yeah, y'all. How's everybody doing? It's been a while since we've been in person. We've been doing remote for the past couple times. But how's everybody feeling today?
I got a show deal.
Okay.
A fitness show called Check Your Ego. It's gonna be pretty cool. Yeah.
We have been checking out the fitness journey you've been doing on. You know,
you played my legs.
I really did though. I'm like, tell me, them bony legs ain't squatting no
405 pounds.
That's a lot.
I've been chasing 500-pound women literally all my life, and all of them have seen the sky. So I'm just physically for it, man. I'm just adapted.
That is hilarious. But shout out to that man. So new TV show, and it's called Keep Your Ego. Keep your ego. My bad. I did say ego. My bad.
Check your ego.
Check your ego. My bad. Check your ego.
No. Keep the ego. keep that ego.
It's called Check Your Ego. Yo, shout out to Khalif Baker, man, because he was the reason I even got on this whole little fitness journey. And yeah, man, I'm owning a gym. I'm opening up a gym.
This is going to be so fun.
You should
vacation. Look.
Well-deserved vacation.
Yep. I'm turning my phone off. Love y'all. But yeah. I will not be available.
Michelle came into work today and said, fuck y'all niggas. I'm not going.
I definitely did not say that.
I don't know. I heard that last word. I'm like, what did she just? I'm joking. Not Michelle. The audience have been asking, is Michelle black or white? There's your answer right there. No, I'm joking. Oh my gosh. Cam, how you doing, brother?
I'm good.
That's awesome. Well, look, you know, gotta start off with a dad joke because you know the crowd loves him.
I was.
It's a lot of hard ones, but I think I'm gonna try this one. What's 3 inches long, stiff, and women go crazy for it?
No one did I know.
Not three, but okay.
A credit card.
That's good.
Clever.
You know, you can tap it, can slide it. All right. So anyway,
That was a good one. I try.
So I don't know if y'all heard recently. So Tyler Perry has a new film out called Divorce in the Black. You can check it out on Amazon Prime. Stars Megan Good, Corey Hardwick, and there have been back and forth, you know, responses on the film, right? One is saying, okay, it was dope. It's, you know, popular film. I think one of the popular ratings that scored it around like 87%, something like that. But
as far as
viewership
rating was like 80 something.
Okay. And now Rotten Tomatoes, which is a national known film and television like critic website, they scored it at 0%. Now, all my life, I've never seen a movie with 0%.
I've never seen one where they
scored
zero.
Yeah. So,
like, not one redeeming quality.
Not one. Wow. Not one. And I'm like, wow. So, how bad? Like, so long story short, comedian Lonnie Love had recommended, well, you know, Tyler Perry needs to invest in writers and directors, specifically black writers and directors. So, we've all had the conversation on the style and the themes of all his shows and movies, and Tyler Perry is known for making the exact same thing like over and over and over again. But I mean, it sells. What's your thoughts on that?
It's all right. If Nike came out with a Jordan that looked like a trash can, people would buy it because it's Jordan it's just part of the line of shoes that they drop. Like, you know how collectors are, you know how shoe hype beasts. They'll buy them Jordans no matter what they look like.
Very true.
Just because they want to put it in their collections. Tyler Perry films are the same thing when it comes to a certain demographic of black folks. They're going to watch it no matter what.
True.
You know what I mean? They're going to watch it. It's just because of his name.
Well, and I feel like, too, like...
It's funny that it has the exact opposite effect for me.
Oh, well, you
watch it because his name is on it.
Yeah.
And see, but for me, I'm that person where, okay, you know, black director, black, I'm going to check it out. Because, you know, that's just me. I always want to, even if it's
almost bright, guaranteed what the movie's about. I've never seen it, and you asked about it, and I've laid out the plot.
I thought you saw it. I thought you lied to me. I'm like, you just nailed the whole movie.
Never seen the
From beginning to the end.
Do y'all get tired of seeing the same themes that are portraying
black
men in such a negative way? And And they portray, a lot of his movies portray black women as weak individuals, and we know that not to be
well. And to answer your question, yes, it gets annoying. And what Tyler Perry is continuing to, you know, remind everybody his upbringing, because both his parents, his mom was in an abusive relationship with, you know, he never saw eye to eye with his father, even though he still, you know, would compensate him, but make sure he's taking care of all the goods, but he does not know at all relationship with, you know, with his dad, very tight with his mom. So he puts that into his work. But in the beginning, I was like, okay, boom, Madea, hilarious character. Cool. When you see some of the drama films, okay, I see what you're saying. And then it's a light at the end of every tunnel. What used to bug me in the beginning though, and not saying all, but when like a lot of white people would highly embrace Tyler Perry's work, and to me, it bugs me because I'm like, don't assume that this is the norm that happens within the black community. And that's where I got frustrated. And that's why I think I get more frustrated when it's constant. Same, I think his shows on BET Sisters or all the other, you know, drama shows. Yeah, it's the same thing. It's like, it's not.
I've watched Sisters with my wife, and the men in there are either mad weird or backstabby, like very soft, like the
cheating. I do not like it.
Tyler Perry low key hates men. Like
I
you think?
I feel like that, but I also another part that troubles me too is like if the point is to make, and this again, forgive me if this seems ignorant. If this is Black entertainment, promote. Like, why don't you highlight? Yeah, every single person, doesn't matter your race or culture, has issues in relationships.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And there's issues, you know, with men, with women, with the kids. But highlight some positive things in some of your movies. Like, how about have a whole movie that is the complete opposite of the theme of women, Black women being weak and Black men being abusive and cheating. Like, have something outside of that. Like, because that happens in every culture.
Yeah.
White men abuse and cheat. White women can be considered weak, but also white women cheat. You know, they're the same issues that are in these movies are all cultures have these issues. So if you're doing Black entertainment, to me, I want to see something that makes me feel like uplifted towards, like, that you love your community to this level.
Like, he doesn't even have to do a relationship.
Get out of, exactly. Yeah. Get out of that.
Do a different genre.
Do an action.
Do a comedy.
It's a show called the Family Business. That's not his show, but it's literally like a almost like Black Mafia kind of thing. To me, that's dope.
Oh, we love a Mafia.
Change it up.
Mafia film.
Change it up. Shout out to 50 Cent. 50 had a show on, I'm forgetting the name of it, but there was a guy that was in prison, but he was also an attorney, and he became an attorney in prison. Oh, he became an attorney in prison. Okay.
Defended himself.
And to me, I thought that
based
was
on
so
a true story. I want
to
say,
and that to me, that was like, that's what I'm talking about. But that's took cool. a guy who was like still building up his media portfolio as far as a, you know, I guess a media mogul, in 50 Cent. I'm like, Tyler, you could not have thought of this whole time. So
brother can't do a space movie. We ain't got too many Black sci-fis. Brother can't do
are we going to space? You want to go to space? I don't want to go to space, though.
Man, not to get off topic, but did y'all watch Supercell?
No.
I think it's Supercell, the name of it.
I don't know.
Black Superheroes on Netflix.
Black Superheroes on Netflix?
I think it's based out of London. Dope. You should check it out.
All right.
A lot of foreign films. They winning right now for me. Foreign TV shows and foreign films.
You know why, though? They starting to use people's actual voices from the regions they're in. So going back to earlier Netflix movies that's foreign, they use white people's voices for like Japan men and, you know, in Arabian women. And always, hi everyone, I'm Billy. But the guy is clearly Black. But the voiceover be a guy from... Like, but now Netflix are using the accent.
Hey, Sarah, be catching that when he watching.
That's another one.
Dude, that's five. I got it.
Netflix was known for doing that. Like, it'll be a movie strictly based in India, but no one has an Indian accent. No one. And I'm like, you couldn't hire no voiceover actors from India? No one who knows English.
Hey, well, look. Long story short, Tyler, you know, take Lonnie Love's advice in consideration because obviously he won't, man. He's a billionaire. He's obviously like saying, why stop? Why stop?
People not going to stop watching. Like, they're not going to stop watching. He already knows he got them in like this loop. They're not going to stop watching.
And see, he's a smart businessman because BET is like giving him so many like opportunities for him. Like, he's creating like his own like channels within their streaming platform because why? In my opinion, BET is a struggling, you know, company right there. So they're like, okay, we need all the content we can, you know, bring in. So yeah, Tyler's gonna be like, okay, I can do whatever, I can, you know, put out whatever and stuff. And it's I'm not a fan. Will I, you know, still check it out? Yes. And you know, the movie, I thought Divorce in the Black was actually good. I thought it was an interesting film for Corey Hardwick to star in because publicly he went through a bad divorce.
one of the twins, Tio or Tamara, right?
It was bad, but he
seems like a shitty husband. I watched one of the interviews.
He played that role too good. Man, he played that role
I
too good.
Interviews with him and which one was it? Tia.
I'm a Tia. Yeah.
So he's married to Tia. Man, I watched that interview and he like basically told her, like, like, bro, you talk about how you trying to make a marriage.
Tyler Perry said, "Oh, I got a film right there for him. I got a film right there for him."
Drafting it.
I wonder if Tyler got a. there's no way that he didn't meet not one positive male figure growing up. That's impossible.
But, had to be but somebody. Syrok, think about it. His most popular character that he plays is known for beating shitty husbands and shitty men. Like Madea only fights men. He don't be fighting.
I was gonna say the money's in the stereotypes and the tropes. That's what people are following in to see. They're not.
But when you follow that character, Madea was also loose. She was a hoe.
Oh yeah.
Oh.
She was a stripper. She says all the time.
She used to be a stripper and everything. So she had to.
She said she used to drop it like it's hot. Now she can only drop it like it's warm. All right. Like, I mean, that's so said from a deer herself.
I believe Syrok, you're up next.
hey, that was my line. That was my line.
Talking about Tyler Perry and drag used to be a hoe. I'm not doing it.
Cam said a bullshit.
Well, we all messed up our check from Tyler Perry Studios.
Dang.
It's never too late. It's never too late. We can, you know, no, it is. Okay.
Dude, if he's, trust me, if he's doing the same.
Will movies, Packer, Spike Lee. Come on.
There we go. Somebody change.
Somebody. Mario Van People. Somebody. All right, y'all. Look, it's time for our favorite segment of the show. It's time for Syrok, man. What you think?
Attention, please.
It's time for Syrok. What you think?
Hey, 757 and beyond. What's going on? It's stand-up comedian Syrok Foxx. And because I didn't do my homework, I'm going to let the my man Cam ambush me with a new one. Something that I have not heard this question. Okay, I did a little bit. I got an idea what he's about to ask, but go ahead.
So,
man, what you got for me?
So, Michelle kind of assisted in this one, but we basically want to know from your perspective, like, what makes a relationship not work in your eyes? What are some things that you've seen and witnessed and maybe even help people out with that this telltale sign, like, this is it, it's over.
Okay. So the easy low-hanging fruit is the communication line, like I always do. However, that's any pretend relationship expert can hit that communication thing. That's absolutely talk, blah, 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 blah. Mm-hmm. That's old said and done with. What I think the best new way to check yourself when getting into a relationship from the very beginning is the tell the truth of who you are from jump. And don't surprise nobody when you get tired of, you know, what's it called? The veil or the mask, or there's so many different ways to describe it. But a lot of people pretend to be this person that they are when they meet somebody of interest. So say I'm interested in Michelle and I want to date, but she's interested in men who likes comic books. I'm more of an animation type of guy. Eventually, if I lie and say, yeah, you know, I'm down with comic books too. Eventually, that little trope is gonna fall. That veil is gonna fall. Mm-hmm. There's no way for me to keep it up for too long. You can only pretend to be someone else until the real you just kind of slips out. And I think a lot of times, and this happened to me personally, a lot of times a person will pretend to be somebody else until they try to sneak in the real you. Mm-hmm. I mean, the real them. And then next thing you know, you like, I don't like this person.
Yeah, that's
and,
right.
Like, I'm not cool with this person at all.
There's nothing in common.
Matter of fact, you're pretty shitty. Like, I don't like you at all. Like, da-da-da-da-da. You don't talk. You don't communicate. You don't share, you know, your ideas, your dreams, your nothing. You just blah. But in the beginning of the relationship, you were all of this.
Yeah.
Now, what I'm trying to say, tell my own experience without snitching on somebody. But
I already got a story.
The biggest problem that I've seen personally was someone being interested into the poly lifestyle that me and my wife were looking for. And that person ended up, the truth was they just wanted me. Mm. Like, the truth was they just wanted me. It was just a rock what they was interested in. And they were trying to figure out how to get rid of Mrs. Foxx.
Mm.
And you can only hold up that charade for so long when I'm coming to you talking about all the good things that she did today.
Right.
Or, man, you won't believe what she did for us. She got us tickets to see da-da-da-da-da. It's going to be fun. Da-da-da-da. And that person trying to come up with a reason why I shouldn't like her. It's like, so you can only pretend to be another person for so long before shit hits the fan and you like, all right, let me show them who the real me is. And then you next thing you know, you blaming, you know, the person who you were lying to for switching up.
Yep.
When in reality, you weren't shit to begin with. Like, you were.
So I got a quick question. This is unrelated, but it's for you too. So, like, poly's a lifestyle, but say there's somebody that say, I just want to have a threesome. That's totally two different things. Like, have y'all ever interacted with somebody that just said, well, I just want to have a threesome, but they didn't tell you. They made it seem like they wanted to be.
Yes.
Okay.
And that is part of the veil.
Gotcha.
Part of the veil.
So I can see like, come on, let's do it. Hold up. We're going to eat. We're going to pray first.
Yeah. And some people who just want to have fun. And look, if you just want to have fun, say it in the beginning.
I got you.
You can do that with single, you know, monogamous relationship too. If you just meet somebody and you like, look, to tell you the truth, you are a very physically attractive person. I want to rock your world. I hope you rock mine. What do you say?
Yeah.
And if they say no, well, you got to take the L. But guess what? There's going to be a million people who say yes.
Yeah.
But you so worried about the rejection that you try to put up this whole, oh, you so beautiful. I love your heart. Oh, I want to be your man in your life. I want to take care of everything. You should move in with me. And then as soon as you get the draws and you get post-nut clarity, you like, why is this bitch still here?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Nigga, you lied. Like, you lied. This woman has fallen in love with you because you sold this dream to get the draws. Now you got the draws and she's left there like.
But, you know, sometimes, though, you cannot blame them for trying to avoid the rejection, because who in this world wants to be rejected? I mean, rejected.
Dog, for every woman that'll say no, there's 10 that'll say yes. That's why when at this big age that I'm at, there was no reason for me to tell any lies about what I'm looking for. The reason why I have two wives is because 100% honesty worked the best.
Mm-hmm.
I told them all of my flaws. I'm very selfish. I'm very self-centered. I am very goal-driven about my career. I care an astronomical amount for my children.
Mm.
Like, you're not going to come first.
Mm.
And to a lot of women, that sounds terrible. But when you, like, actually boil down to it, and that's that whole different conversation, it really is about taking care of everyone that's in my clan, everybody that's in my group. Like, those qualities, those self-preservation thoughts and everything, they might sound selfish up front, but in reality, it is to take care of my household.
Yeah. Gotcha.
I tell the truth, then they don't. They already know what to expect. They know that I'm going to be at work right now, and they texting right now, talking to each other about how I can't talk right now because I told the truth. When you there's fellas, I don't want to bust him out, but he ain't shit. So I got a friend who. He always lies to women when he first meets.
Wow.
And his success rate is 10 out of 10 single time. But he's also 39, mad single, lonely every night.
Yeah.
Reason being is because these girls figure out what he's really about after 2-3 sessions with them. It's like, oh, you just wanted fun and you sold me a dream.
Yeah.
And then he's acting like, oh, all you hoes are the same. Sir. You said you were a doctor. You dropped out of school freshman year. That was very specific.
That was very specific.
Did he ever say he was a doctor of medicine? I mean, there's so many doctors.
I was going to say he's a doctor of love.
Dr. Dre, you know, Dr. I'm saying there's so many doctors out there.
So let me open the floor real quick to a couple questions. The first one being, then don't, this is transparency, because I'll answer my own question. I have lied to get the draws before.
Mm.
We talked about this before.
Yep.
We talked about this before, and I remember you saying, no.
I haven't.
You've never lied to get the draws?
To get the draws, no.
Minor lie.
No. Whoa.
You got more.
Oh, Cam is just such a good guy.
I'm not even a good guy, just that I know that shit is going to blow back. So, like, it ain't worth. If I got a lie to get it, then I don't need it.
Well, and I think it's really smart of Cam to, because Cam is already thinking what the response be, or, you know, at the end, rather than just
feel like 17-year-old Cam was definitely
17-year-old Cam was a virgin.
Oh no!
Yeah.
Well, I guess it's not a bad thing.
Yeah.
I was a hoe. I forgot.
I wasn't lying at that age. Not to get it.
Have you ever lied to get the dick?
It's not hard to get dick.
Yeah, that's what I say. Really, women don't have to lie.
But that does not answer my question, Viver.
The lie is like, I've definitely lied in relationships, which I regret deeply, you know, because I was scared to lose the person over them finding out like things that I've gone through in my life or who I've been previously. And I've definitely like lied while in a relationship, but to get a relationship. I don't remember ever lying.
He didn't say relationship.
Dick.
Yeah, I'm about to say. He didn't say relationship. Is it harder to get women? Because you said guys are easy, but is it hard to get women, Michelle?
Yes, it is harder to get women. Yeah. It's much harder. It's way more difficult to have sex with women than it is men. But I've never had to lie to have sex. If you just look at a man a certain way, a lot of times, if they're into you already, that's all you got to do.
We're just easy like that. We're just like, all right.
I would say, on
your way to the house, what's your name again, by the way?
To defend both men and women, I think it's hard to get the draws from a good man or woman. I think it's hard to get the draws from a good woman. I do. I think it's a challenge. Mm-hmm. Now, there's 20, 30 women that I can think of right now that would come in here and
it depends on the setting that you're into. Because I feel as though like if you're at the club, everybody's like saying, okay,
dude,
I hope
we are at Rugged Evolution. There's a girl named Champagne that would give us the whirlwind of a doozy. Like I'm telling you, she would go crazy and we don't have to tell a single lie. But there's also women. Don't worry, Mrs. Gavin. Champagne ain't never came to the office.
you know, when your aunties or your grandma, whew, what are they talking about?
But I'll tell you, so I hope men listen to me when I say, for every woman that'll say no to the real you,
yeah,
there's dozens, if not hundreds, of women that'll say yes. So there's just no reason to lie. I just hate the ones who lie to me when I'm telling them the truth about me.
Yeah.
And I think that's how relationships be ending so tragically.
Hey, I mean, I learned my lesson, and the first person that I was honest with ended up being my wife. So like when I was probably like a senior or junior in high school, and I was dating this girl, and she was into screamo, and I'm like,
screamo,
like heavy metal, like that. Yeah. So man, she's like,
you wanted her so bad, you convinced her you was into that shit.
Listen.
Oh, my God.
So she's like, I'm like, yeah, I listen to, the devil, such and such. Yeah. Oh, that's my shit. That is my shit. Yes.
He's like, Marilyn Manson is on my playlist.
What? Right now.
My man said, I listen to the devil.
Yeah.
Listen to it backwards, too.
Man, when I tell you, she said, well, look, my brother, he's in a band and he has a concert this weekend. You want to come? I'm like, well, yeah. Man, I tell you, I went there and that's when I found out what a mosh pit was.
Yeah.
And, you know, everybody was just like, you know, hey, and you could not hear yourself breathe. It was in like a hole in the wall spot. Somewhere was very suspect. And I'm just like,
had you listened to the music at all before that?
No.
You didn't even listen to a song before you went to this thing?
I mean, maybe like the evening of, like, just who is she talking? Just so I can at least have my spark
notes.
So
when you
ready.
Heard the blah, 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 you didn't know what that thing
I
was going to be?
I thought somebody was dying. I really thought, I'm like, where am I? So, but I like horror movies. Wow. So I'm like, well, how gory can it get? Man, I got that. I was just, by the time I left and it was like no music, my head was still like rattling throughout.
But see, there's guys who will change their whole identity for a pussy. Like, there's guys.
Now, I guess I can't say I didn't change my whole identity. That's pretty much what I did. That's pretty much what I did.
But there's people who would have took it to the point of they would have dressed the part. They would have had the makeup.
Yeah,
boy.
I did take that part.
Your voice would have been all gone because you tried to.
I literally look like a kid that just left children's church going to a school. Like, you know, like just looked like I was totally out of place. I'm just like,
wow.
Everybody's wearing grunge black and you're in there with a colorful shirt.
That's how relationships end terribly because there's some folks who would make that last for months.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden they just snap and say, fuck it!
Man.
I hate this music.
Man.
I know that's what our relationship is built on.
I'm like, why are they hurting each other? They fighting. Yo, step away. Oh, that's just the mosh pit. I'm like, God dang. Like, who else? I'm sorry. If y'all out there that enjoy being in the mosh pit, please get some help. I'm sorry. Please get some help. I saw people get broken noses and like, I'm like, why do you continue to run when there's arms and legs and stuff? Sweet, like I don't understand it. But it was.
I think it can be summed up too as you know, why, and I kind of, we talked about this a little bit yesterday. Mm-hmm. I feel like relationships end because of one of two reasons. Under everything else falls under this from my perspective. Either you don't love yourself enough mm-hmm. or you love yourself too much, more than you probably should. Mm-hmm. And you can't love other people. In either of those situations, you can't love somebody else and you can't be honest with them. You can't, you know, be healthy for them because you're not any of those things for yourself.
And definitely. If you hiding things about yourself, then you definitely yep. don't love yourself enough.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. But that was my little story. But no, that's a great, that was a great question, Cam. That was a really great question.
Yeah. Well, bullshitting. That's what it is. That's what we end in relationships. Bullshit. Not bullshit it.
Has Tyler Perry done a movie about that?
About bullshitting?
I think he has. Yeah, I think he has.
You mean all of them?
Yeah. My bad. Oh, we should take a trip to Tyler Perry Studios just for like on Cam's birthday or something.
Like, I'm so impressed with him. I'm so impressed with him, but like there's something.
I love what he's doing. I just don't like
yeah. He just don't like the products. Yeah. I don't like the products.
Yeah. Dude.
Make I a just better wish variety. It was good. I just yeah, want yeah. a better variety. Yeah.
But that's how we've always been. We've always said Tyler Perry is doing amazing things, but it's like, why is he doing such, like, it's amazing, but it's like he's choosing to be trash. Like,
yeah. It's true.
It's like he knows he has his audience, so he doesn't have to improve.
No.
And it just don't seem right.
It's going to be like a forever ongoing combo until we start seeing some new writers. Well, that too, and start bringing out some newer, like, off the wall content when people are like, oh, I never saw this coming yeah. from Tyler Perry. That's what we're waiting to see.
Maybe that's what he's setting us up for.
Maybe
that might be what it is.
25 years later,
the veil comes down eventually, right? I said there's no way that he thinks men are this
talk
shitty
about the long
in every
game.
Movie. I'm telling you, the veil gotta eventually break. Maybe this isn't him. Maybe he secretly want to do sci-fi films and he's trying to ease black people into it in some tactful way that we just don't understand. I'm telling you, there's a moon scene somewhere in a movie coming soon to Tyler Perry. We're gonna be on the moon and somebody gonna be on drugs.
Hey, guess what? You know what's gonna pop up? Madea on space.
Telling her kids to leave her husband because she's getting beat by.
I'm walking right out.
Oh my God.
I'm walking right out.
In space.
Madea in space is hilarious.
In space.
It's gonna bro, she's going to be floating. The wig going to be coming off. Oh my God. It's funny.
She's going to be shooting an abusive drug dealer who's beating her niece. It's going to be crazy. And then there's going to be Shamar Moore with braids trying to. He's going to be like, you deserve better. You deserve to be loved like the queen you are. And she's going to be like, really? And he's gonna be like, yeah. And she's going to sleep with him one time and then go back to her husband. It's going to be amazing sci-fi film.
Oh, gosh.
Madea goes to space. You heard it here first.
That's right. Exclusively here on In Your City. Oh, that's how you feel. That's how you feel. Okay. Well, I think it's around that time. Michele, you've been, you know, just waiting to give us your segment. Well, it's time for Michele's Corner. What you got?
It is now time for Michele's Corner.
All right. Well, we obviously went shopping. I'm going to go shopping too. Yeah. Anyway, so we're talking about relationships today, and I saw this video, so I want to play that for you guys, and because that's what I want to talk about, a little controversial perspective on marriage.
I want to know from women over 35 if cohabitating with men is really worth it.
It's been said before, but I'll say it again. Marriage isn't really good for women. Women don't benefit from being married to men. The comment section on this video is full of women who say this, happily married here. And I say this without weirdness, but if he dies first and he knows this, LOL, I will not do it again. So many of the comments came from married women, women who claim to be happily married, who say they would never choose to live with a man again. And I think this speaks volumes about the dynamics that exist in our culture overall, right? When men get married, they expect their wife to take care of them, to cook for them, to clean for them, to take care of their children, to have children for them, and they go off and work. But in today's world, these women are also working. And so not only are they working full-time, but they are also expected to care for the home and the children and do exponentially more work in the home than their partner. And oftentimes these men have been raised without the information or expectation that they'll take care of the home themselves or take care of the kids. And so even when they try to help, they need a list. They need her to tell him what to do. And it's exhausting for women. It's been shown that marriage isn't actually good for women. Women who are single do better than men. Also, having children isn't really good for women, right? We have the wage gap, the motherhood penalty, and the fact that having children can put women at a higher risk of financial troubles in the future, right? Marrying men, living with men, and having children doesn't quote unquote benefit women in the same way it does men, which is why so many women say they would never do it again. And that's also why so many men remarry so fast.
Wow.
I feel like she is one of the ones that's saying that shooting was staged, that assassination attempt. Like she's
I just want to unpack. I want to unpack a couple things because I watched this video a few times. And obviously, as you guys know, I've been married twice, divorced twice, and I am single now. And a lot of people ask me, you know, do you ever want to get married again or would you get married again? And I think a lot of people are surprised by my answer because I've been divorced twice, which, by the way, I don't recommend going through two divorces. It's literally.
Is that your expert?
That's my little plug, my little expert advice. Just don't try to avoid it. And I have to take accountability for the fact that the divorces I have, they were just as much my fault as the other person's. It takes two people to make it or break it. And, you know, from one way or another. So when I hear a woman say this, there is a large part of me that is like, I was exhausted when I was married. I was exhausted because I was doing what she said. I had to have a full-time job. I had, you know, two toddlers under the age of six. I had to come home and do laundry and cook and clean. I had to do absolutely everything. And I was raised to do that. I was raised to be the person to do everything in the house and to take care of the kids, help them with their homework, pack their lunches, and to still get up at 5 a.m. and go do a full-time job and still work out and stay in shape and stay looking nice, you know, for myself and for the person I'm with. And it was very, very exhausting. So I do understand that perspective, but I also think on the other side of it, I think it matters a lot, you know, before you get married to have those conversations. You need to establishing, first of all, that this person is healthy for you and not only for you, but for your lifestyle is important. Me as an entrepreneur now, I have obviously three businesses. I'm very, very busy. Would I get married again? Do I want to get married again? Yes, I do. I want to have the person that I'm supposed to be with for the rest of my life. I want that. I want to have somebody that I wake up, you know, beside that, you know, adores me, that wants to, you know, grow old with me. Like I'm crying. I'm always crying. I want that. But
every time.
But on the flip side of it, now at this age, after going through divorces, like I have, I respect and love myself enough to know that if a person is not going to be healthy for my lifestyle and where I'm going, meaning the person who would have to be in a marriage with me, you're going to have to do laundry. You're going to have to cook. You're going to have to help clean the house. You're going to have to run my son to work here and there. Like, you're going to have to be a person who is very active in helping me in my life just as much as I'm going to be active in helping you. And if that person is not of that mindset, I'm not going to get married. So I don't think it's not that it's so horrible for women to get married. It's just women, like you said earlier, we'll play the part that we think a man wants us to play to get the man, to get the wedding ring, to get the house, to get, you know, the marriage itself, to be the mom. But then we don't always think up front before we jump into that mindset of let me get married, let me do these things, of is this person actually going to be healthy for my long-term goals? Whether it is to be a stay-at-home mom. I love stay-at-home moms. I did that for years too. And it was very fulfilling for me, not as fulfilling as being a business woman, but it was very fulfilling for the time in my life. And I didn't mind taking care of the house and doing the things I needed to do. But for she's speaking specifically, I feel, for career women, women who have their own business, women who are working a 9-to-5 or maybe two part-time jobs. She's speaking to women who are working and being the stay-at-home wife. And so my perspective from that is you have to you have to know what's healthy for you and not healthy for you. Just like I said earlier, this, you know, loving yourself, not loving yourself enough or loving yourself too much is a problem. And I think women have an issue a lot with not loving themselves enough to know that this individual is not going to be good for their long-term goals. And I think men do that sometimes too. And then they get caught up in, you know, in an unhealthy relationship with a nagging wife. That's the thing.
Maybe I live my life different. Do people not live together before they get married? Am I the only one who lived with my wife before we got married? That's dumb. No, okay. Y'all are stupid.
No.
Like, anybody who's getting married to a stranger is dumb as fuck to me.
No, I agree with that.
Change. I would never.
Literally at all once you say I do.
I would never marry someone before no, I live with them.
I did live with my second husband for a year. But that's my first husband, I was 17. Married. I got married a month after high school, so we couldn't live together.
And I feel like
we had no funds like that.
I think a year is good. I think a year you really get to know that person.
There's no way.
Wait, a year of what?
You think
a year of cohabitating before you get married.
There's no way that you can know a person.
But you kind of, well, you kind of
living together.
But you're kind of doing that throughout. So okay, so check this out. Say you and Shauna, okay, you're already dating. Y'all are now considered boyfriend and girlfriend.
Right.
That doesn't mean immediately y'all start living together. Y'all can still be living apart and still be boyfriend and girlfriend. So technically, you're doing the cohabitation anyway.
No.
So,
No. Cohabitation is literally 1,000% living together. It's shared bills. It's shared.
You should live with the person at least 2, 3, 4 years before you even start talking about marriage, because your life still hasn't adjusted to that person yet. Like, when you first move in for a year, that's a roommate. I've had roommates longer than a year.
Yeah.
And I couldn't stand the motherfuckers by the second year.
Mm-hmm.
There's no way. Me and my wife, I think we were together damn near 6, 7 years before we got married.
Yeah,
no, maybe longer than that.
That's not going to be the thing.
It should be. We've been together 15 years.
I think y'all were going to work either way, though.
I don't think
6 years is necessary. At most, I think two.
By year six, I knew exactly how she thought, moved. I can predict everything.
The 6 years.
Your life should not. What's the difference? You're going to be married anyway,
but
right?
But what if in year five you realize it wasn't?
Then you break up. And
in my opinion, 2 years feels like 4 years. To me, I know we always say, "Man, boy, the time goes by real fast." But to me, 2 years is a lot of thinking. I know exactly how this will be, living condition, all that good stuff. So,
but the first 6 to 12 months, honestly, I've tried to move in with people in the first 6 to 12 months, and then we broke up. And honestly, it did save a lot of heartache.
That's why
sometimes you live in with them part time. Like, you might say, okay, I'm gonna just chill here for like
maybe
a few
that's
weeks
why
and then.
I didn't understand the question when I got married, and everybody was like, "How's life treating you? How's life? Is it different?" I'm like, no, motherfucker.
Not if you live together. But
yeah, if y'all live together for that long.
That's
period,
what everybody should start doing. Just like this woman who was talking. It's like she's talking about how you got to hold up these standards. But why weren't you used to you living with this person before you said I did?
Okay, but check this out. So then if y'all have your own home together, not married, y'all been together, I don't know, whatever, how many years you said.
We wouldn't buy a house together if we're not married. So that stops that question.
Okay, it does.
I wouldn't buy a house with a girlfriend. That's just not something you would do.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, never mind then.
Fiance?
No. No.
Okay.
No.
I think that's a very good idea coming from.
And that's how everybody in my family has been. And there's no divorces. So that's why I'm like, what's going on with. Mm-hmm. I'm confused. How are you. Your life should not change at all by the time you say I do. Because you are already used to your life. You've already adjusted to your partner.
It's like a checkerboard. Like, I agree with some of the shit you're saying wholeheartedly.
That's the thing.
Of the shit that you're saying, I could not disagree with more.
The only reason y'all saying it's abnormal is because y'all are taught, you know, you go with somebody. After a few years, you get married. And after that, you move in. You start a life.
No, I did things way different than what I seen in my family. Because I moved in with my ex-fiance and we've lived together. And then at that point, we realized that it wasn't going to work.
And that shit.
But it was by design that we live together so we can get to know each other and see if we could actually live together. And it didn't work. That's why I agree with part of what you're saying.
That's good.
Yeah. But I just, I don't agree with the length of time by which you're saying before you get married. To me, the length of time
shouldn't matter if you plan on being with this person for the rest of your life anyway. Like, if the goal when y'all, even when moving in, the goal is y'all want to get married one day, right?
Absolutely.
It shouldn't matter when.
I guess what I'm saying is by year, you said year one is not long enough.
Oh, no.
I kind of agree with that. But I think by the second year, you know that person. I believe so. You know that person. You've been through multiple holidays with this person. You're sharing bills now. You've had company. You see how they how they clean the house. You've seen every how they live. Mm-hmm. Like, you've seen, like, it's a window now. You see everything. I figure by the end of 2 years, there's not much you don't know about that person unless they're hiding something.
It may be different for me because you got to add the deployment status too.
Oh, absolutely.
So there are times where I'm gone. When we did move in, our first time living together back in California, 2011, I want to say, when she first really moved in with me.
Yeah.
And at the end of 2011, I got deployed. And I was gone. And I came back. And I got deployed again. And I came back and I got deployed again. So that's
very different.
And not even do those times not count? You're kind of starting from square one every time you come back. Absolutely.
It's like starting over.
Absolutely.
Every time.
Difficult.
So yeah. I'm just confused on why life is changing at all. Even for this lady, she's talking about how she had more work to do and da 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 da. But
she
like
had
you
a bad
didn't
partner.
Already have that
I was
work
say, before I don't you said think, I well, do. That I don't too, think she's speaking like, for the majority.
No, like, she's not. She had a bad partner. That's what
so
it was.
We got another lady in the studio today who's good, hey. Going to be getting married. Right.
Well, she's not
I think we might need you to come over here and weigh in on this because I was
Are y'all getting married?
I see your facial reaction.
Ain't nobody said I do's. Did nobody
you
propose,
come
right?
Over, look, you want to weigh
put
in?
These people on black. This is about to get so
come on.
Yeah. Let's,
she has like not got proposed to.
Yeah. Let's.
Well, I would say what that lady had said that I do agree with, though, and I've said this many times to all my friends. God forbid if, you know, I would not want to get married again after, you know, if this ever, like, no.
So you feel that way?
Hell yeah. As far as getting married again. I mean, now relationship. That's perfectly fine, but marriage, no.
Why is he 80?
Why is he
so old?
Because
he's in his mid-20s.
I feel as though, like,
and he talk about marriage,
but I'm saying marriage puts in a lot of work. And then after, it's like going to war. You're exhausted after a certain amount of years, you know, building up.
Arrington, and all. How long have you been married?
We've been together for 8, but we've been married for 2.
Okay. Relax.
So, but I'm just saying.
It ain't a bad marriage.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. He's talking like it's hell, and I'll never do this again. Like,
look, all right. Yes, we're happily married, but it takes work. So that's how I just leave it. It takes work.
But, all right. So God forbid you and Shia didn't work out. Don't work out. We know you are. But God forbid, wouldn't you think that your person would be out there somewhere? You think you're going to be single for the rest of your life?
No, I said relationship. I specifically want to be married. I just would rather just, you know, this would be my girlfriend what's wrong with that, though? I'll just be honest. There's people in my family I've been together for 20 plus years and never been married legally. It's like, They love each other. They might as well just be, you know, they're already pretty much.
But
other
if
than
those people got married, nothing would change.
It wouldn't.
It yeah, wouldn't change.
Literally nothing. Doesn't change.
They can
anything.
Start wearing a ring tomorrow. It changes nothing.
But this that but that's the thing though. But that's the nothing. Thing.
That's why there's not such thing but as that's common law marriage.
If a ring changes something, there was already something wrong with your relationship to begin with.
That's true.
On my that's on
well,
everything.
Look, I'll just
that's
say true. Y'all not speaking for the majority because I wholeheartedly will tell you stuff will change once marriage happens.
So you're saying as frugal as you are, you don't want that tax deduction again?
I get less money back getting married.
So don't speak about your own relationship because I don't want you to be on the couch tonight. But what changes after, especially if you are already living together?
What changes?
I personally feel like certain commitments change when the title changes. When it's like, okay, my wife says this, then I
told
like
you
a
not commit- to. Oh, okay. I was about to say.
No, I'm just saying. I feel like commitments apply before you were married. No, but I'm just saying. I feel like commitments change when it's changed from girlfriend to spouse. That's just me personally.
Wholeheartedly disagree.
What changed? You should be though? That. You're saying commitments, but not which commitment.
Okay.
What changed from the day before you got married to the day
like,
after?
What happened?
I feel as though I'll just say, okay, I'm gonna be home at this time, right? But I get home at a certain time with a girlfriend if we're either living together or not living together, but they're my girlfriend, it won't be an issue because if I get home late, then how would that be an issue?
It's gonna be if it's an issue after you get married, it's gonna be an issue before. Are you kidding me?
It was an issue before you got married. It wasn't like
it when didn't you just were girlfriend snap boyfriend into being an together, issue.
And but, you showed but, up at 1 o'clock in the morning.
But I'm saying one is living together, one is not living together, so it won't be the same.
And that goes back into my.
But okay. We didn't say that. We said getting married.
Getting married.
But so
already
if,
living
if
together.
You should already be living together before you say. That's the bigger piece of it. Moving in together, I feel like, is a much bigger step than getting married.
Getting married. Oh yeah, absolutely. That is the most serious thing you can do.
Completely agree. Yeah. With that. Mm-hmm.
So moving in together is the biggest commitment you can
mainly because explain because everyone's saying it's a big commitment, which I don't disagree. But I'm just saying
for the same reason that you just said the commitments, and now you're again. I keep saying it like you have. This shared financial situation, all these things combined now.
Is it mainly just the financial aspect of it?
That's a big part of it, but it's life together.
You're adjusting to a whole nother person living with you for God knows, like, you're waking up next to this person.
Yep.
Which you don't get no break from this person.
Not one.
Yeah. You don't get to go to the living room and not talk to them for a few days. It don't work like that.
Because what are they going to do? They're going to walk right down to the living room if they want to have that conversation.
Y'all are together.
There's no go home to cool off.
There's no separation. There's no, I'm just going to chill in my room. Y'all got the same room.
There's
no bigger commitment than moving into you. Yeah. And then once you do that for a certain amount of time, once you hit your threshold, whether it's 2 years, whether it's 4 or 5, then you be like, well, this is a good life. I choose this.
Yeah.
And then you say, I want to get married. But the whole we girlfriend and boyfriend, you living off the east side, I'm in the south. Let's get married. That's the dumbest shit that I've ever heard in my life, bro.
Yeah. Because
you do not know this person.
After years of being together, still, you're saying that's still bad.
My limit, I can't marry a person after 2 years. 2 years is just not long enough for me.
That's
the situation I was in. You know, you add personal personal stuff. So you got deployments, you got, you know, trouble with the law. Mm-hmm. Remember, I was a wild motherfucker.
Mm-hmm.
So I wasn't at that stage where you could even get to know me because I didn't know myself. Mm-hmm. So it took me longer than 2 years to be like, I wanted to get married. But 2 years is amicable for a lot of people can rock with that. The point is that y'all live together.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
That's the point.
Overwhelming. Now, the only place I would agree with you is if y'all weren't living together, you got married and then moved in. Then I agree with you.
And I'm sorry, if that's your situation, that was insane. That was the most insane move you pulled. Like,
now you're getting to know her.
Yeah.
And like, it's too late. Like, you already did. You can't be like what Gail did. Like, you kind of suck, low-key. I'm spitting. You kind of suck. I want to move.
But that's what I'm saying. Let's not think that stuff like that though doesn't exist because it does. Because I mean, not trying to get into religious aspects, but you go, you know, one of my good friends from India, their marriages are planned. They don't live together. Yeah. They don't damn near know who they're marrying. Absolutely. But it's planned now. That's to crazy. Talk how their relationship is now going. You know, hey.
But that's also a way of life for them. So that's something. That it's implanted. But like they know that's what it's gonna be.
It's like I said, on religious aspects, there's people that do the opposite of what you know. You're saying
for sure. There are.
So
they get divorced too. And they get divorced too.
They.
But I mean,
as soon as they get Americanized and they watch Sex and the City, it's over.
It's over. Wait, I can have a husband who don't beat me? Yeah. Oh, that's an option. Yeah. I'm out of here.
Thanks, Tyler Perry. Thank you. Oh, thank you. God. Didn't know this exists.
Man, yeah, yeah. So with her, to me, everything that she described is her fault because she chose that life knowing she didn't like it. She chose to work full time and take care of the kids and da, 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 da. And the husband probably thought, well, this is cool. She like to do a lot.
Yeah.
I'm going to marry her. This is a good life.
I got it made over here.
And it turned out she didn't like none of that shit from the beginning. And it goes back to SyRok, what you think? Saying you shouldn't have bullshitted. Yeah. You should have said you wanted somebody who
from the beginning say, I want help.
From the jump.
I'm not doing 110%.
Everything. From the jump.
I'm not 110%. Doing
I don't know, I feel like culturally, if it's like men are always the one that's doing the wrong, because that's the one thing I was thinking when I was hearing this. Again, she's not speaking for all women, but it's just like, oh, here we go again. Like, how many videos are we gonna see of a woman saying like this?
Oh,
and
it's
the
men's
other?
Fault.
Because I can't relate. There was a guy speaking like that, but he's dead now. Kevin Adams? Kevin Samuels.
I can relate to him either. I just can't relate. I don't meet them that many. You know that whole like
I can't stand hearing critics speaking against or about relationships when it's like, so where's your wife? Where's your girl? Where's what? Oh, there is no one to be found.
Like, he was divorced, right?
He was not married.
He was definitely single because the woman that was with him when he died was like a model or something like that. Like he was just fucking around with. So yeah. He was definitely single.
Hmm. A lot of the motherfuckers, though, who be saying all that stuff on the internet about how bad the opposite sex is are single. And they are terrible people today.
Oh, your boy Derek Jackson wasn't single.
Oh, my God.
Derek Jackson.
That's the one
Derek Jackson
was cheating on his wife and making all those videos talking shit.
Oh, the big bodybuilder dude.
Oh, I forgot about him. Yeah.
And then she taught him a lesson after. After that.
I forgot about Derek Jackson. Yeah, he was the green screen guy.
Leave him, girl.
Yeah.
If he can't commit to you and hold your hand in the rain while it's drizzling, he ain't worth it. Like, he would be saying stupid shit. And then all the shit that he would speak out about against dudes, he was doing it.
Yeah.
He was doing it.
Yeah. Terrible. Terrible. Them people suck.
Absolutely.
People suck.
Absolutely.
People suck.
And it's poison. Like, I know they're doing it for a check or whatever, but they're literally poisoning the minds of people.
Yeah.
And having
people
them
truly believe that.
That there's no good people out here. Yes. When it's obvious. Come on. I saw a dude on Twitter talk about black women so bad, and then he had millions of people engaging.
Yeah.
I mean, the tweet itself had 3.5 million views.
What?
And then there's thousands upon thousands of quotes and thousands of subtweets under that saying how bad black women are. And I'm the only one who's saying, man, I haven't met none of these black women y'all are describing.
Right.
And I'm the simp. How? I'm the simp. These people are around you. You need to change your environment.
Yeah.
The place where you at, it sounds like everybody is shitty.
Look, controversy sells. And then, look, people would rather have, say, thousands and thousands of comments speaking against them because they know, hey, look, I'm catching their attention. I'm making my money, like you said, just for the check. So
I can't relate. Yeah. The women around me are amazing.
Yeah.
I can't relate. The husbands around me are amazing. I can't relate. I don't know the niggas.
Well, right. Well, I guess that sums that segment up.
Yeah. Well,
we can't relate.
Well, look, that might be the title of this episode. We can't relate.
I like that, actually.
Tyler Perry's film.
We can't relate.
But
there's nothing but good men and good women, and then some toxic motherfucker comes into the scene and
he ain't
fitting in because everybody looking at him like, what the fuck is wrong with you? What do you mean? Black women are bad. Get out of here, you weirdo.
Can't relate. Well, look, before we edit, y'all, we can't finish it up by bringing up an historic moment that happened recently. The assassination attempt of former President Donald Trump. So you heard me kind of speak in the beginning with. Oh, you about to? Gotcha.
This is the Trump supporters.
It's a fast and trade. Yes,
I know.
Yes.
I know.
They
taping it.
So let me tell you something. I have been criticizing both sides on this case. One side is saying it was staged. Another side is saying that it was orders from President Biden. And I'm like, both of y'all need to
order a Happy Meal.
Get a life.
That was pretty good.
I don't.
That really was good, Michelle. That was a good one. That was a good one. That was Michelle's first.
That was a good one.
Wow. That was.
I'm just saying. I don't understand.
The timing, the wittiness. I really fuck with that.
How can we help you, sir? Really can I?
Nah, these are.
He's trying to talk.
But these
Kamala
are,
Trump
these are,
Harris.
These are our real choices this year.
Yeah, it's like wild.
Nothing is changing.
Here's the thing. I'm going for the.
The third guy never wins.
Well, here's the ongoing like discussion, right? And we got like 4 months until the actual election day, but a lot of people, a lot of key Democrats in high positions, they're saying, he should drop out. They're saying Biden should drop out. We should start looking for some contenders now. And they should have done that way in the beginning, they effed up on that one. But because I've said it out publicly, like, because of after that moment that happened with Trump, he's already declared the winner, in my opinion, just because the man gets up, blood drizzling down his face, puts his fist up, and they get a shot of the flag waving behind him. People are already getting it tattooed on themselves. So
he won. It's not even a fact that people like Trump more. It's just that Biden's base is not going to go out to vote.
They're not on one accord.
What I was explaining to someone. I was like, the only reason Biden won was the fact that people showed up. Showed up to keep Trump out of the office. Now they're not going to show up to vote for someone they don't have any confidence in.
Mm-mm. No. Did you think it was weird they don't want to vote for Trump?
So they just not going to show
not
up
vote.
Or not
right.
vote at all. Did you think it was weird though? Like 5 days later, now Biden tested positive for COVID. I was like, who's the biggest victim this week? Like, I was like, are we playing the victim card? Like,
shot is a weird. Little.
I know, but it's weird. Like, why all of a sudden, it's just
COVID put one person down, a bullet didn't.
For 100 years old having COVID? I mean,
this is my only thing. I've seen a lot of bullet wounds. That man would have been missing a lot more than that little piece of. I'm telling you, his ear would have been.
I mean, even Evander Holyfield is like, you would have
been able to smell Trump from the stands. And for some reason, nobody said it smelled like old people. Like, no,
but here is the proof where I say it was real.
I think it was the prompter. I think it was the glass that cut him.
Okay, so you're saying the glass that cut him, but it wasn't because a bullet was shot because one of the spectators there was killed.
Did they ever actually say Trump shot? They just said assassination attempt.
No, they never actually said shot at.
I don't think anything ever got reported that he was shot. If you think about it, to your point, it could have been glass.
I haven't even seen a clear picture of the shooter. No. The picture they've been showing is some Twitter troll.
Yeah.
Well, you did
look like the
you
guy.
Did see the video of him up on the roof, though.
Really?
Right?
I seen that. Yeah, I seen him who was all laying dead. But the picture who they was showing is another guy who's tweeting right now, like, y'all, they killing me. It's not me. Like,
wow.
I'm still alive. I'm here. Like,
I mean, and then to help people's argument that might say it was staged is like, okay, this happened. This had to happen a day before the RNC convention, which is like a big, huge national convention where they basically nominate we're going to vote for Trump as our nomination. So it happened. The assassination happened the day before. When he was heading to Milwaukee or something. And it's just the timing is weird. And like you said, Biden all of a sudden, like he said, I'm staying in the race. No one's going to put me down. And then he has COVID. You know what I mean? Like, it's just like, does he have COVID based on like, he's just saying, hey, look, I have COVID. So I want my legacy to be better.
Say that because he I don't know if this is true or not, but I do remember one of the statements saying that if he had a health condition, he would step down.
It was true.
Do COVID count?
It's a disservice, in my opinion, just for like voters. Because
the Democrats dropped the ball, bro. Yeah, they dropped the ball.
You had people that wanted to run that said, hey, look, much respect to Biden, but we just think in this case, we really got to start looking next in command or start, having some changes. Didn't want to look that into consideration. So now
4 years. It is what it is.
That, I've told that. That's what I've said. I'm already like mentally prepared. I mean, I sleep good with whoever's really in office. But my whole frustration with the whole Trump thing is just he brings on so much chaos because you got to look at a lot of his supporters, man. A lot of his supporters don't like people like me, you know, with my complexion. They don't, they're not for same-sex marriage. They're not for women's reproductive rights. They're not for really equality for a lot of people, right?
They not just even want for the technological, advancement for America. They can't stand it.
And I'm,
can't stand it.
That's because of religion. A lot of it is.
And that's BS too, because trust to believe they, you know, they make Christianity as the part, as the religion for the Republican Party. And I actually got into it with a girl that was very conservative. I said, look, if y'all all pro freedom, this freedom, that, you want your rights for, you know, for guns, you want your rights to have certain amount of taxes, this and that, and the other. Why isn't that people can have the, you know, I said, why is it that you want the nation to be led by Christian values? I'm like, to me, that's kind of ass backwards because we live in a world with so many religions. We have, you know, Jews, we have Catholics, there's so many other ones, but why is it that? So she never had a response from me. Never had a response. It's just it's a lot of hypocrisy going on with this. But yeah, long story short, Trump has a new album coming out soon, you know, with the whole
he got signed a deal with Verizon. Can you hear me now? Selling working with Mike Tyson. They now selling
working Mike Tyson
ear bites. Yeah, he got it going on, man. Trump won. We can't do nothing about it. No. We might as well. There's joke nothing to do.
No,
dog. He got the black power fist in front of America, bleeding. Dude, these white people about to go crazy. Like, they're walking around.
Hey, you think Dr. Drake is gonna create some like new beats or something for him? You know,
beats by Trump. You only get one.
Who's a proud endorser for him now? Amber Rose. She out there in the political world. Go ahead, Amber.
Yeah,
bad self.
How much you think they paid her?
A lot. A lot.
They had her up there as rapper, by the way.
I never heard of an Amber Rose.
I never heard nobody be like, hey, yo, put that new Amber Rose on, Z. Put that Amber Rose on. She's slick.
Y'all literally go from the old man singing, and I'm proud to be an American, to the girl that created, was it Slut Walk? Something.
Yes.
The woman who's pro-choice. Did they forget?
Yeah, apparently.
Amber Rose is mad pro-choice. Did she forget?
Bro, it was so
funny. She didn't forget how much money she got.
And y'all know I'm a political buff. I watched a good portion of this convention. So one night was all, or their theme was unity and basically trying to get all the black votes for Trump. Oh, they had a night where it was all like minorities on stage. Ask me how many I counted in the crowd.
Two.
You said how many?
Two.
They wouldn't let in. They probably didn't even let the people of color in. They could have had the MAGA hats, and they still didn't let them black people in the convention.
like that just blows my mind. Like, make America great again. Like, I'm sorry, for me, that phrase just seems like I'm sorry. It's just it's unfortunate, man. It's really unfortunate. But a lot of people just they want it on the economic standpoint. Like, I'll be honest,
man. Look. If I woke up pregnant today, I wouldn't be pregnant
tomorrow.
We'd all
be rich.
That's just how it is. Oh, if I woke up pregnant today, I wouldn't be pregnant tomorrow. I ain't got no... And that's one of the main reasons I don't rock with Republicans.
Mm.
Because that pro-women's choice thing, you can't make me have a baby, bro. Just because I physically can't, that kind of puts me out of the conversation.
Mm-hmm.
But if men woke up and we were all pregnant...
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Dude. Abortion pills would be selling like hotcakes.
Cause it's either natural. I don't a C-section. Mm.
Oh
no!
I'm telling you, I'm yeeting my black ass off. Yeah. I am yeeting my. Woo! I'm sliding first. I'm not going to get one. And then all the other men going to be pregnant and be like, yo, Sarah, how you did? I don't know. It didn't take. It didn't take.
It just sucks, man. It just sucks. I mean, no one should lose their personal right. And it's just, and again, I mean, women has it the worst because it's already, you know, you're talking about wage gaps and then, you know, take it. I mean, it's just this. It's crazy.
Hey, there's a movie idea for Tyler Perry. Pregnant men.
Pregnant men.
Men wake all up. Right. And
you know
places.
Tyler would do that. They now, you
places.
Know Tyler would do that. If his one thing he go do is to pregnant
wait,
man.
So you mean Madea wakes up and she pregnant? What the hell?
We don't gotta, you know what? I'll take a
huh?
Second.
Huh? Wait. Huh?
Come on, the photo lady waiting at the bar down the street.
Many men wish death upon me. Blood in my eye, dog, and I can't see. I'm trying to be what I'm destined to be. And niggas trying to take my life away. Put a hole in the nigga for fucking with me.
All right, y'all. Thank you for listening in the In Your City. Be sure to follow us on IG on In Your City 2, as well as all social media and digital platforms. We appreciate you. See you next time. He had his hat bad. Oh, 50.